Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to look at trapezoids. Okay, what is a trapezoid? Well, trapezoid is a quadrilateral. What does that mean to be a quadrilateral? It means that it has four sides, but it is a special type of quadrilateral. It's a quadrilateral that has two sides that are parallel. In other words, one pair of sides that is parallel. So up here I've drawn a trapezoid, a very archaic picture of one, but just so you can see, we have four sides and we have two sides that are parallel and two that are non-parallel. Okay, so notice these two sides are not parallel to each other and these two sides are parallel to each other. Here's a second one where these two sides are parallel to each other. These two sides are not parallel, but they are congruent, which means they have equal length. Okay, so let's look at the rules and we're going to talk about the names of those, okay? So the rules are trapezoids only have one pair of parallel sides. So two sides are parallel, two sides are not. The angles in a parallelogram always add to 360 because it is a quadrilateral and all quadrilaterals angles add to 360. Now under trapezoid, you can have a special trapezoid called an isosceles trapezoid. And just like an isosceles triangle, an isosceles trapezoid has two congruent sides. So the non-parallel sides are congruent, and then the base angles would be congruent. So let's go back and look at the isosceles trapezoid a little bit more carefully. This one is not isosceles, it's just a traditional trapezoid. This one is an isosceles. Now I'm gonna redraw it so you can see another characteristic of an isosceles trapezoid. I like to turn my parallel sides this way. I just think it's easier to see it. Okay, so if these are my parallel sides, these are my congruent angles, these base angles down here are going to be congruent to each other, okay? And then these larger angles up here are also going to be congruent to each other. So I'm going to throw in some angles. Let's say this one is 120. That means this angle would be 120. Now, the whole thing adds to 360. So if I subtract the two 120s, that way I'm going to subtract 240, because if I subtract 120, 120, that adds to 240. I'm going to have 120 degrees left, aren't I? Now if I divide that by 2, because I've got these two angles left, each of those little base angles is 60 degrees each. Okay, so that's how it works. Another characteristic, if you'll notice, if this one is 120 and this one is 60, these two actually are supplementary, which means they add to 180. So that's another clue there. But that's how you would figure it out and how you find your missing angles on an isosceles trapezoid. Hope this was helpful.